Hello, and welcome to this talk on Semantic Similarity Metrics for Learned Image Orchestration. In this talk, we will answer the question of what do we want to align with our orchestration models. This is joint work together with my supervisors, Osvin Krause and Åsa Farragon from the University of Copenhagen and the Danish Technical University. In image registration, we want to align a moving image I to a fixed image J through some geometric transformation phi. In our case, the transformation is a dense vector field, meaning for each pixel in one image, we try to find the corresponding pixel in the other image. And this is an unsupervised setting, so we do not have a ground truth transformation. All we are presented with is the two images, and we have to infer the transformation. We try to find an optimal transformation phi star by minimizing an energy equation or loss function consisting of a distance measure d, where we judge the distance between the aligned image I composed phi and the target image j, and a regularizer r. In this regularizer r, we regularize the transformation. We can encode constraints on the transformation here. So usually we want to avoid domain folding, and we can also encode prior beliefs about how bendable we think the material is. But I want to focus mostly on this distance measure or similarity metric in the loss function. This similarity metric judges how good our current transformation is. So we apply the transformation to one of the images and then compare the aligned and the target image. And ultimately, this is how we judge how close are we to a perfect registration. And this is quite instrumental for both driving the optimization process and also influencing the final result. Common similarity metrics you find in literature can be grouped in three categories. So there's intensity-based similarity metrics. This is, for example, a mean squared error, where we align pixel intensities. It's a quite simple and easy to understand approach, but it comes with issues, especially when registering across image modalities or registering images that have been recorded with different devices. And the matching is often ambiguous, as all we look at is these different grayscale values. An alternative is key point-based image registration, where we look at key points or points of interest in the images, and we are trying to find a matching between them. But this, of course, brings us immediately to the question of what are good key points and what is a good matching for them. And often this is done by hand annotation, which then takes a lot of time and this is not really feasible for many application areas. And finally, there's correlation-based similarity metrics, where we look at patch-wise correlations between the images. An example here is the normalized cross-correlation. Compared to intensity-based methods, correlation-based methods are more robust towards variations in brightness and contrast in the image, and thus they are often a popular choice when we deal with images that have been recorded on different acquisition tools, follow different protocols, or even of different image modalities. But both mean squared error and normalized cross-correlation focus on aligning pixel intensity values. So the assumption here is that as long as the pixel intensities of the two images match or are strongly correlated, then these images are well aligned. But I want to challenge this assumption. I think image registration should align areas of similar semantic importance instead of relying on just matching pixel intensities, because pixel intensities are often not a good description of the actual meaning of parts of an image. And thus, I want to introduce a fourth category here, which is semantic similarity metrics, where we focus on aligning the semantic contents of an image. So instead of aligning individual pixel intensities, we want to align areas that have a similar function in the image or a similar meaning. Now, how do we go about designing a distance measure for semantic similarities? Well, let's first look at the popular normalized cross-correlation measure, which, as I said, is a patch-wise measure. And we can write this down as the similarity between two patches A and B is the cosine similarity between two zero-meaned patches A and B. So ultimately here we look at the pixel and we describe the features of that pixel by the zero mean patch around it. So the patch is acting as the descriptor for this pixel here. And I thought, hey, we can adapt that for a deep semantic metric. And this is where I introduced DeepSyn as a patch-based metric. So for two patches A and B, we again take the cosine similarity between them. But now instead of zero meaning these vectors, we use this function big F to extract a semantic representation of these patches. Now the question is, how do we find a good semantic representation of these patches? But thankfully, we are doing deep learning here. And deep learning is really good at learning representations of data. So we can use a surrogate task, like for example, a segmentation task in this case, or also an autoencoding task if you want to go with an unsupervised approach, and train the surrogate model on our data set. And when we do that, we learn a bunch of kernels in our model that are really good at extracting the semantic meaning of the images. And we can use these kernels or the feature activations from the layers of our network to extract these representations. So for an input image I here, now when we're looking at the feature activations, we get different representations of our image that highlight parts of the image that are particularly important for the meaning of that image. And now we can take these representations and put them back into our DeepSyn metric. And we end up with a metric like this, where on the right side, we now have the cosine similarity between these semantic feature representations. We average these over the pixels of the image, and we average them over multiple layers of abstraction. So by taking into account different layers of abstraction here, we look at both localized concrete features from the shallower layers of our network and more global abstract features from the deeper layers of our network. And in effect, we are building a feature pyramid here of semantic features. And then we train a registration network with the semantic similarity metric. So we take a quite standard unit-based registration network in blue here. We feed our images I and j into the network to predict a transformation of phi, and then use this transformation of phi to warp one of the input images to obtain our morphed image I composed phi. And now we use our previously trained network to extract these semantic feature representations and feed these representations to our loss functions. Then we finally compute the loss and backpropagate it through the network for training. We evaluate this on three different data sets. So row-wise here, we first perform ATLAS registration of T1-weighted brain MRI scans. Then in the second row, we have slices of human blood cells under an electron microscope where we align neighboring slices. And in the third row, we have a video clip from the cell tracking challenge, where we have a cell swimming around in a solution and we are aligning neighboring frames of this time sequence. We compare our method to multiple baselines. In the columns here, we first have the moving and fixed image. Then we have the mean squared error. We have a normalized cross correlation. We have the normalized cross correlation with a supervised component. We have the VGG network for an image classification. And then we have our DeepSyn similarity metrics trained with both an unsupervised autoencoder and the supervised segmentation network as a feature descriptor. And we use white grid lines here to visualize the transformation. For quantitative evaluation, we look at the mean dice overlap on the test set. And we see here that on two of the data sets, our DeepSyn metrics perform best, or the models trained with our DeepSyn metrics perform best. And on the third data set, we see that all models achieve very high mean dice overlaps here of over 0.97, and the supervised metric performs best here. But in all three cases, this deep symmetric is among the best, while some of the baseline methods sometimes work well, sometimes don't. You often have to try. We also observe smoother transformation fields with our deep symmetric. So here we have we highlighted a noisy background patch from one of the data sets. We can see with the normalized cost correlation that tries to align these image patches, we get a very non-smooth transformation field in the background of this image, while our deep symmetric is much smoother here. So it seems that our metric learned that there's no semantic meaning in this background noise. It's just background and it doesn't matter for our registration task. And accordingly, it doesn't try to align this noise. We have a more detailed evaluation of both hyperparameter choices and the smoothness of the transformation in the paper. And we also continue to use this metric in ongoing work. So this is a preprint on topological anomaly detection with registration models. And you can see in these rock curves here that the blue line is quite a bit higher than all the baselines. And this blue model has been trained with a semantic loss, while all the baselines use a mean squared error. So we see that semantic similarity metrics are really applicable in other tasks as well. And they can make quite a large difference whenever registration is involved. So to summarize my talk, we introduced the semantic similarity metrics for image registration. It achieved a high registration accuracy across multiple datasets and tasks. We can learn this metric from the dataset either through an unsupervised method using an autoencoder or a supervised method using a segmentation model. And while the supervised method performs slightly better, even in the unsupervised setting, we gained an increased performance. We also observed smoother transformation fields in the presence of noise. And finally, I want to highlight that this is a general similarity metric for image registration, which is applicable to different image modalities and also different algorithms. We don't have to use this in a deep learning context. We can also use it for more algorithmic image registration. The code and experiments of this talk are available on GitHub. So star me, fork me, cite me. And thanks for listening to this presentation.